comedic actor Seth Rogen was on Stephen Colbert just last night and told a story about refusing to take a picture with the House Speaker, Paul Ryan. Listen.
They said, our dad wants to meet you. And I turned around, and Paul Ryan was walking towards me.
Oh, okay. How'd that go?
Well, I didn't. My whole body puckered, as it were. I tensed up. And I didn't know what to do. And he came over, just grabbed my hand, and I'm just like, I'm shaking his hand. I don't know what to do. And he said, can I have a picture with you? And I look over, and his kids are standing right there, expectantly, clearly fans of mine. And I said, no way, man.
So, Jack, how do you see this, that, you know, this divide, whether based on politics or otherwise, is really permeating everywhere?
Well, you know, but we all have a responsibility. I'd say that shows a lot about Seth Rogen. What a little punk. Now, it's ironic because he's with Stephen Colbert, whom I've been on his show when he had the Colbert show, and actually did a vignette with him and Nancy Pelosi. Now, we don't agree philosophically, but we had this great little riding a bicycle together and sliding around the halls of Congress. And I got to tell you about Stephen Colbert. When staffers came out of their offices, because Steve Colbert was there, he gladly greeted all of them. He let some have a picture with him when it was appropriate, Democrats or Republicans. To me, while I disagree with him, that shows good personal behavior. And I think that being a nice guy
Let me say this. Doesn't everyone just have the discretion of, you know, making a decision, making a call like that?
Jack, it's my turn. Let me tell you this. I actually didn't know you were going to play this, but I was actually there when that happened. That happened at the Romney retreat in Park City, Utah, a couple of weeks ago. Seth Rogen was there, not for politics. He was there to talk about Alzheimer's and Alzheimer's research, which is something that affects his family directly, and he has been raising funds for and raising awareness for. Paul Ryan was there with his wife, Jana, who's a friend of mine, with his two kids. And look, I think we go back to the same issue. You've got to respect people. You've got to respect people. He was not disrespectful, but you've also got to respect people's conscientious objections to being associated with somebody that they find objectionable and offensive. This is America, you know? We don't have to take a picture somebody that we don't respect and that we don't like. He was fine. He was nice. He was courteous. He spoke for over an hour to a room of Republicans, mostly Republicans.
You got your point. But let me say this. I agree with you. He has that option, and he was nice about it, and that's good. But he wasn't a leader. Now, Bono, who comes to Congress quite often to lobby for overseas foreign aid, good stuff that he has found Democrat and Republican responsiveness to, because even though he's a hardcore liberal, he's worked with many Republicans because he's shown leadership. And he's saying,
those are different examples. That's trying to get something done or trying to accomplish it.
I don't want my image to be used
to help advance someone else's agenda or thing. So those are totally different things.
Paul Ryan is a big boy. Paul Ryan knows that this comes with, you know, membership has its privileges and it has its costs. Right. And, Paul Ryan took it in stride. And frankly, Seth Rogen is not a political leader. Seth Rogen is an American citizen with the same rights that every one of us has.
But if you're trying to get something done,
it's the times.
You work with other people. I chaired the committee that funded Alzheimer's. By the year 2025, there may be over 10 to 15 million people have it. It's a huge problem. If he was really dedicated to that, he should be polite to somebody who has great influence on how much money we put in.
Listen, do not question his dedication to that. Seth Rogen. I heard.
No, I certainly don't. I don't think he's doesn't sound like my kind of guy.
His mother-in-law is suffering from Alzheimer's. He has been incredibly involved. And so it really is just not, look, that he didn't want to take a picture with Paul does not mean you can question his motives and his dedication to the commitment of the cause of Alzheimer's.
Anna,
it's called
Anna,
Hilarity for Charity.
Anna,
and he has
Anna,
raised millions and millions and millions, much more than you've done, Jack. So really,
okay, Anna,
watch yourself.
Yielding to
you
time, it, let me say this. As somebody
it's ridiculous for you. It is ridiculous for you to question the
will
commitment
the gentlewoman
to
yield to somebody else
of
on
a
the
guy
show?
Who
Anna,
is dedicating his life to
Anna,
that.
Okay,
I mean,
you got your filibuster
going.
Let me just say this. As somebody
no,
who has sat
yourself.
In Congress,
how
as somebody
dare
who has voted, and somebody who has directed spending, I can tell you, people can use their celebrity.
I mean, you are ridiculous.
I don't know if I'm going to get any time, Fred, or not. If I could, this
you
is the
shouldn't.
Point.
You shouldn't. I'm doing you a favor by not making this point. Because
Anna,
you are being absolutely
time,
ridiculous
maybe it's possible.
That you are
Anna,
questioning
you can
a person
time.
Whose own
Fred.
Family
all right, hold
is
up, Anna. Okay, hold up, Anna. Okay, so
you want to take a picture with
okay,
so
Jack,
whatever you're saying,
Jack, complete your thought.
Fine. Could I speak? Fred, here's my point. As somebody who's chaired the committee, mm-hmm. who has directed spending and a lot of research into Alzheimer's, I have seen lots of celebrities, Democrat or Republican, step forward and use their publicity, their bully pulpit that publicity has gotten them, to direct spending. And you all feel good because at
okay.
the end of
but
the day,
Jack, okay,
you're
real quick, that was back
cause.
To the
whole
there are
I'm
two
saying.
Different situations. You know, there's the goal of trying to get something done and saying, okay, I'm going to work with people on both sides, et cetera, you know. And then there is the, well, this spontaneous moment comes up. I just made a choice, you know, that I don't necessarily want to be used as an advocate or show that I am in step with anybody's position because, you know, I don't know how this imagery is being used. So it looks like there were two, you know, these are very different examples that we're using here. But bottom line is, you know, some folks are expressing themselves vociferously. Some are doing it very quietly because we are at a place where it's very clear there is a great divide on so many issues and so many levels. I appreciate you both.
Thank you.
Ana Navarro, Jack Kingston, thank you so much.